The picture is good or not from the moment it was caught in camera. I love this quote. Because everything that we do, everything that we understand about photography leads to making moments. That's what it's about. All about the moments. I want to share some with you. Wonderful story here. This bride, her name is Ro, she called me 3 days before the wedding and told me that grandmom is not going to be able to make it to the wedding. Grandmom's the closest person in the world to her. Cliff, before you take me to see Joel, her husband, can we stop at the hospital? And I said, well, of course. I knew I was going to make something there. They're sharing a rose, sharing the smell of the rose that's in her bouquet because she can't make it. I was really moved to tears, as I am sometimes. You ever get that feeling when you take the picture and you get the goosebumps and you get the chills and you say to yourself, holy shit, I just made a picture. I made something. You know the feeling, and that's why you're here. That's why you're photographers. And that's why I'm still doing this after 29 years. God's honest truth. Whenever I feel it, that goosebumpy feeling, I shake a little bit, and I felt that here. And I feel it once or twice a year, like I said before. Grandmom died 2 weeks later, for real. Ro called me when she got back from her honeymoon. This photograph, she said, they weren't done yet. They weren't processed yet. Do you have anything? I sent her this picture. It's in the casket. It's in the casket. 5 minutes before the groom is about to walk down the aisle. Now, if I didn't understand light, and I didn't see this instinctively, he was only there for 15 seconds. 50 millimeter lens on my, this was old, this is the D2X, okay? Couldn't go above 640, you know? God, 640, I mean, that's unheard of now. Now I go to 6400, literally 10 times almost, figuratively speaking. Love this picture. This is just about 2 months ago. So if I didn't understand the creative process and I didn't understand my gear, I would have never made this picture this way. I might have used flash. What would that have done to this picture? Destroyed it. Because, I mean, the bags under this man's eyes. This guy has had a life. He's a Holocaust survivor. And I think I made a nice moment here. I got chills when I shot this. What do you think my exposure compensation was there? I was probably minus 3 stops in order to capture this, at least. There was just an overhead can. And I like the fact that he's got the bags under his eyes here. It makes it even more dramatic. So I wouldn't want to put any fill flash from the front side. This is in a bedeckin in a Jewish ceremony. And I was able to control the creative process a little bit here. Let me explain. I was able to control where the light was going to be omitted from. Because beforehand, they were setting up the bedeckin chairs. And they were set up in the wrong place, a dark-ass area, and I did not want to use it. So I set up the chairs near some window light. And then everything throughout had this beautiful side light. And I like to shoot directly into light, as some of you may know. And I made that one there. Mom's reaching out for the groom. Bride is just crying her eyes out. The moments are what it's all about. Exposure compensation, again, probably down a little bit because I don't want to blow those highlights. I'm in aperture priority, and I'm working it, riding that exposure compensation dial. That's the second he saw her, and that's the second they all saw them. They all saw him. Every single face is making some type of emotional reaction. This is why I do what I do. This is the creative process for me. Essentials of creativity. 5 minutes before he's about to walk down the aisle, this is in a very old church in Playa del Carmen. And I just saw this light, took my 7200, and I had to wait because he didn't go back there. He moved, and I'm sitting, and I'm waiting. I might have waited 2-3 minutes. That's a long time when you think about it, just sitting there waiting for something. And I made few frames. And again, exposure comp dial, way down, way down. So love that picture, actually. Nice moment between little girl and granddad. Granddad was the father of the bride, and he had to control this kid the whole time, right? Studying the relationship between the granddaughter and the grandfather. I predicted something was going to take place there. And these last two images, remember I said earlier, you're always sort of feeling your way, you just never know. And don't preconceive ideas. And don't use blinders of habit. Well, they did their recessional. And they grabbed some flowers, and they walked right out the back of the church. And I had no idea where the hell they were going. They didn't discuss anything with me, nothing. But instead of doing what some photographers might do, which is wait around, because I was going to do some family photos in the church, instead of waiting for them to come back, I had my 7200 on me, okay, another body with me as well, with another lens on it, and I ran out and walked out after them. I had no idea where they were going, but they walked out, they're outside, walk across the driveway, walk into this field, and they go walking into this cemetery. And I said, oh, crap, where are they going? Obviously, I knew they were going to pay respects to somebody. And I was like 50 yards this way. I didn't know where they were stopping, and I don't want to be on top of them. So finally, they stopped here, made this picture here, which I like very much. Then I made that one. He broke down. This won the Grand Award for Photojournalism 2 years ago at WPPI. And that's his grandparents. They raised him. This is why I'm still doing weddings. And this is what the creative process is about for me. Because honestly, if it makes you laugh, if it makes you cry, if it rips your heart out, that's a good picture. Thanks for coming.